What do you think?
You gotta go that way to be able to come this way.
So today's day one on our race truck build.
These mirrors are messed up.
We will find out very quickly how thick our slab is inside the shop because everything is heavy on this.
You got room for the forklift in front, you think, or do I need to back up a little more?
Hey, right here is good.
All right, good.
What's the goal? We're gonna take an over-the-road work truck and turn it into a race car, and we're gonna do it about as fast as we can. Much of it is lightning because everything is heavy on this. We don't need two axles, we only need one, and then our truck is quite long. So we'll be removing a large portion off the back of the truck. I don't need any of the creature comforts in the dash. We'll remove all the AC system, we'll sheet metal the dash, and then we're gonna increase safety, seat, harness, fire suppression system. We'll lock the cab in place, we'll cage it. We're gonna take the fuel tanks from outside the frame rail where the trucks make contact, and we're gonna put a fuel cell in between the frame rails where it's safe. Then when it comes to the motor, our goal is to double the power output on this thing and then increase its ability to turn and stop. So we'll move the motor and trans back and then lowering it substantially.
And the closer we get the center of gravity to the ground, the better it'll go around a corner.
The Series 60, it's a massive motor. It's built to do massive work, and we're gonna completely change its direction and make it go as fast as it can go. And so we're going to put a much meaner turbocharger. So we're gonna have an increased fuel system, bigger injectors on it. And then we're gonna have tuning that handles that appropriately. That's it. Bigger turbo, more fuel, zoom, zoom.
Let's go, listen, let's go ahead and get this thing stripped.
Here we go.
We need to remove everything that makes it an over-the-road semi. The external fuel tanks, the external battery mounts. So it's gonna be a long day of just chunking trash.
Down, 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 down. All right. Now tip them back a little. They're clear so far, just strap.
Go on, you're fine.
I don't think anyone in the shop has any big truck experience. Turn wrenches on them? No. And so we'll just figure it out as we go.
Watch out, them toes. That'd be a 9-toe rustman.
Yeah.
Not that there won't be a couple curveballs, but ultimately, it's just a machine. A man built it, a man can take it apart.
Show that thing who the boss is. Oh. I thought you said you had a hold of it, Chris.
I did. This is going to be interesting at best, watching him build a big truck for the first time. He has a tendency to think everything's easy, but it's going to be a bigger project than he thinks.
Chris, tell me about this.
What is it?
Look at those bolts out there. There are no head on.
They're some kind of huck bolt where they got a hydraulic gizmo that just squeezes them on in the factory.
Well, yeah, but the thread.
Yeah, no. Well, the theory is so you can take them off.
No, you can't.
So I found a bunch of bolts on this truck that I didn't understand because there wasn't a head on either side of it.
It's a lot like a reverse nut nutser.
A reverse nut nutser? What?
Nutser.
Oh, okay.
Reverse nutser.
I thought you were speaking a different language.
Yeah. You know, I don't know. Big truck guys just worry about getting dirty and getting the job done. They don't really care what it's called, what they're working on usually.
Well, I don't have sockets for completely round head, nuts. I have no idea. I've never seen one before, but I'm about to see a bunch of cut up ones.
Oh, yeah. All right. There's a bunch of cut up ones.
Right now, I have one goal, and that's to get all of these off, and I have one tool here that does it really well. I call it the smoke wrench.
Keep cutting this stuff off, it'll all come off together.
Be mindful of all that plastic on the other side of that.
Watch out, I got that open fuel line. There may be a wonderful fire.
I'm going to send someone to Fort Worth tomorrow.
So once we chop off the head with the torch, we still have to get them out of the hole, and the air hammer is just the easiest, fastest, and definitely most fun way of doing it. I don't know how many bolts it takes to hold this thing together, but I definitely know how many they used. It's all of them. This truck has a million miles on it.
We got spaghetti going everywhere.
And so most everything on this truck is wore out.
Hey, Chris, what's the name of the game? I win.
Huh? I loosened it for you.
Sure.
All right, it's time to pull the axle.
Hold on, don't do it yet.
Yep, that's it. This thing ain't even connected no more.
Oh, this whole rear end's loose?
Yeah.
Well, look at you.
About as loose as your rear end.
Look at you.
We're about to have fun, Chris.
Not quite, we gotta pick it up yet. All right.
You ready?
Yeah.
Give her hell, give her hell.
Yeah, girl.
Keep going.
Oh, hey, we're good, we're good. No miles. Okay, that's good enough. Let's clear the frame and chop this thing. What do you think, Chris? Should we cut this truck in half?
Let's do it.
All right.
Yeah, that'd be the deal right there.
Yeah, that's not bad.
All right, let's go cut the red one in half.
Let's do it.
A bigger set of injectors will allow more fuel.
That's number three.
And so more fuel, bigger boom, more power, go faster.
These are the biggest, baddest injectors I've ever laid eyes on. Yeah, there you go. There's a perfect example.
A little different.
That's the difference. So this is going in a 460, and this right here is coming in a Series 60.
Bob and Justin made quick work of the injectors, which is exactly why I wanted them here. Plus, if anyone can push this thing over 1,000 horsepower, it's Bob. So now we've got the injectors. Those are in. Bob's giving the motor an all clear.
Y'all ready for some go-fast parts?
Manifold turbo.
See what you got.
It's time to put the hair dryer, otherwise known as the turbo, on. And Chris has brought a big one for us and a full tilt manifold. So the combination of both should let this motor breathe.
It's pretty.
Well, I'm terribly excited. We just got to get a cam cover put back on and get some of this on.
Hell, we'll have a truck running that. What'd you tell me?
Well, that might not be true.
These things are slower than Christmas until we fix them. They get ridiculously fast. The combination of these things with the new injectors and the new tune should produce the power we need to go racing.
Putting all them pretty parts on a dirty, dirty motor.
Anybody who does anything with turbochargers knows one thing. Just keep ramming it in there and the power keeps going up until something flies off of it. That's precisely what we're gonna do.
Why'd you have to get such a heavy turbo, Chris? You like that?
Should have a recess here. The seal is wrong. It's not pressed tight against that.
You're kidding.
No, sir.
Didn't set even.
This lip and this lip, they're offset, okay? Being that this is all flat, it's literally trying to shove this ring through this.
So I run into a problem trying to install the seal on the front cover because we were missing a part from the seal driver I borrowed from a friend.
This is on where it's supposed to be, but we need to set that seal back, and that's his tool. So I'm not going to cut it on a lathe.
Yeah.
Well, I would.
If we do, we know what it costs us.
It ain't costing
$470. It's not our tool, so we can't cut it. Seems like we're stuck.
Now I have that.
Probably the one for the wrong motor or something.
Entire thing shoved flat on there, and I don't like it.
You gotta figure out how to put that thing in there.
He thinks we may have got the wrong tool.
Hey, can we draw and cut a ring? Create a spacer ring on our machine. I mean, once that's on there and we push the bushing on, it'll basically sit like this. And when we press, we're only pressing from here.
And it'll be flat?
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I think that'll fix our problem. So we need to install the crank seal. So I have to make an adapter ring to fix the part of the tool that's not working.
Just give me a couple seconds to set it up.
Give that a shot.
Let's see if it sits over it.
Maybe.
Yep,
it's loose.
That's a good idea.
Here we go.
John Rodriguez, he's pretty first manner.
Yeah.
This motor originally made somewhere around 430 horsepower. Now, I really feel like we've doubled the horsepower.
Now we're going somewhere.